everybody. That's church language for a time to be quiet. Great to have you all here this morning. We're here, of course, to worship the Lord, to lift up his name. I just wonder, I've got a very spiritual question to ask before we start. Who's seen the Luther movie? I know Celia has, and Bree. I'm in it, so you all need to watch the Luther movie. I had a little stint as an extra a couple of years ago back in COVID, and the movie's only just come out, and it was great fun, and it was something fun to do. But Bree came up to me this morning, she said, "Have you seen it?" And I said, "No, I purposely haven't seen it at the moment, because I was worried that the scenes I was in might have been cut." So, but according to Bree, I'm there. So anyway, let's stand together. I was reading in Revelation this morning, and I love these words, Revelation 21. "Then I saw a new heaven and new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will be with them and be their God, and he will wipe away every tear from their eye. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain. For the old order of things has passed away.' And he who was seated on the throne said, 'See, I'm making everything new.' And then he said, 'Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true.' He said to me, 'It is done.'" Echoing there the words of Jesus on the cross. "It is done. I am the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life." You know, if you're thirsty, if you're thirsty in your life, if you are thirsty in your soul, if you are dry and parched, he will give you springs of living water, and there is no cost. There is no charge. Everything that God has, everything that flows from the throne of heaven is free. Everything that God pours out of himself into our lives is free. There is no charge, and it doesn't matter how many times we come back, how many times we revisit the throne, how many times we seek the face of the Father, how many times we come to the foot of the cross. It is always free, and there is always more. There is always more of God for him to give out. I'm not preaching my sermon early. Let's pray. Father, today we thank you. We thank you, God, that everything you give us is free, that everything you give us is without cost. We thank you, Father, that you pour out streams of living water. We ask, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that today you will satisfy our thirsty souls. Pour out your water this morning, in Jesus' name. Amen.
something, just to say the words of the bridge. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Lord, whatever's gone on, we just give it to you. Lord, whatever's gone on this week, we give it to you. And Lord, we just look forward. We just give everything to you and look forward and know that you've got control. That you are our God, mighty God, everlasting God. And yes, God, you're in control, and we just hand it away.